Hi. Did you know that there was a widespread drought in 2012 in the US? Did you know that this drought was the most severe drought in 117 years in the US? And the cost estimate, the financial losses, was estimated about $12 billion. And it was a huge drought. So probabilistic drought monitoring and forecasting, or PDMF, is a product that by Portland State University, Remote Sensing and Water Resources Lab. Okay. Remote Sensing and Water Resources Lab. And this product is the final product is like interactive maps, where like this video shows, you can zoom in, zoom out, you can like zoom in wherever you want and just click and see what is the drought probability in the next 2 months, next 3 months, next 1 month, and you can see what is the expected drought, like deterministic drought forecast, and as you see in this video, you can just click and see what is the drought type. And you can change layers, like put two layers together and compare them. What is the like comparison between 1 month drought prediction and 2 month drought prediction? And you can change the background, like depending on the purpose you're looking for. And this is another example of these interactive maps. This is, for example, the probability of drought in October 2017. And see, you can put on the layer and just click and see what is the drought probability. For example, the one month drought probability is 30%, 60%, and etc. So this is the final product. And in case you're wondering how we do this is the schematic of the framework. And we run a hydrologic model, variable infiltration capacity, the weak model. And the input data comes from North American Land Data Assimilation System, NLS Phase 2, from NASA. And we run the model, the output is soil moisture simulations. And soil moisture simulation at this point are uncertain. And to make them more like certain and to decrease the spread, we use data assimilation, like particle filtering, that I would be happy to talk about it after the presentation. And we use data assimilation and assimilate satellite soil moisture data, SMAP data, and SMAP stands for soil moisture active passive. And we assimilate SMAP data to the model and get the updated soil moisture. And at this point, we have updated soil moisture and we can monitor the drought. So this is the first phase of this project, drought monitoring. And then for the next phase, we use this updated drought, these updated soil moisture estimates to forecast drought. And what we use for forecasting drought is technically a multivariate statistical model. And it's a purely statistical model just to predict the drought given the like last month drought. And the final product would be short-term, medium-term, and long-term drought forecast. By short-term, I mean 1 month, and by medium-term, I mean 2 months, and by long-term, I mean 3 months drought forecast. So we tested the model, we evaluated the performance of the model for three cases of drought that we knew there was a drought there. One of them was 2013 and 2014 drought in the Pacific Northwest. One of them was the 2012 drought in the United States that I just talked about, and also the famous 2014 drought in California. So let's talk about the 2012 drought in the US. In the middle, you can see what the US drought monitor from University of Nebraska shows how they monitor drought. This is the monitoring product, not the forecasting product. And on the first row, you can see for May 2012, And second row is for June 2012. And third row is for July. This drought initiated in May, okay? And you can see it at the beginning of May, the USDA was not able to catch this drought. And how do we know there was a drought? Because 7 states in that area declared drought, officially declared there was a drought there. And you see that the US drought monitor, just at the end of May, shows like a moderate drought. But here is our deterministic, most probable product. So you can see that here in this area, we are showing drought. And if you take a look at those bars, you can see the red bar is our drought extent in those 7 states, and the blue one is US drought monitor drought extent in those 7 states. And you can see that the state, like the extent of the drought is higher. And here, okay, so the model was able to catch the initiation of the drought, the onset of drought. And the peak of drought was in July. And you can see that the model is still able to catch the peak of this drought. And if you compare the bars there, you can see they're pretty similar. So here, so the last slide was deterministic, most deterministic forecast, most probable forecast. And even our probabilistic forecast shows high probabilities in this area and for those 7 states that declared drought. And you see higher drought probabilities, but you cannot find in the US drought monitor. US drought monitor just gives you the deterministic droughts, but here you can see the probabilities. We are assigning more than 80% probability of drought to this area, which clearly shows the onset of the drought. Okay, but as I said in my first slide, the product has 1 month, 2 month, and 3 month forecast. So here, again for May 2012, on the first row, you can see the forecast for just May. In the second row, you can see the forecast for May and June. And in the third row, you can see the forecast for May, June, and July. Okay, and on the third column, you can see the spread of the US drought monitor, how it varied, because US drought monitor is a weekly product. It's not monthly, so I had to use videos to show how it changed during time. And on the first column, you can see the deterministic drought forecast. So here are the most probable drought, expected drought, and in the middle column, you can see the probabilistic drought forecast. The US drought monitor is not the only product that we like use for comparison, use for validation. So we also use NASA GRACE root zone soil moisture monitor and also US NOAA's US seasonal drought outlook. So if you take a look at the seasonal drought outlook, you can see that this was released in April 19, okay? And this was released in end of April. And you can see that NOAA SDO is not able to catch that drought again, but here we are assigning high probabilities, little high probabilities to that area. This is for 3 months ahead, okay, for the whole summer, not just for May. And okay, by now I talked about how the model was able to catch the famous droughts of 2012. And now I wanna take some time and talk about the operational element of this product. So here is the latest product, the latest results that we got from the model. And this is for October 2017, just a couple of months ago. And this is the just for the 1 month October. And here you can see that some sort of higher probabilities are assigned to Montana. And if you take a look at the US drought monitor, you would find this drought. Other other results, other maps that are produced operationally, like for October, include moderate drought, probability of moderate drought forecast, probabilistic forecast of severe drought, and extreme drought and exceptional drought. So you can see that there is no chance of exceptional drought in October 2017, and we really didn't see any. And this one is the seasonal forecast for October to December, like right now. And we released this, this result could have published in September 2017. And as you can see, again, some sort of drought is like detected here, and the rest of the US is not in drought. And here are other seasonal products, including the probability of moderate drought, extreme drought, severe drought, extreme drought, and exceptional drought. And nothing is like obvious, no drought. So these are some movies to show how these interactive maps could be used. So the tool gives you static maps and interactive maps. The second row is interactive maps for deterministic forecast, the most probable forecast. And the third row is the forecast, are the interactive maps for probabilistic forecast. So here you can choose whatever you want and just click and get the map. And also the second row, you can again just change the background layer, change the like add layers you want to add. And also here is a legend, and whenever you click, you can see the drought type. And this is for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. And here is the forecast. And with this, I want to end my presentation. I want to say thank you to my advisor, Professor Hamid Murathani, who has been very supportive of me in my PhD, and I'm very proud of him. And also my colleague, Dr. Hongshan Yan, who has been very helpful and supportive. Thank you. And I want to thank Steve. Thank you. And NASA. Thank you very much.